before the fall. All of us on some level experience pride, which is not to be mistaken with confidence. At times, we find ourselves walking a tightrope between the two. Confidence is based in knowledge and experience, and thus has roots. Whereas pride is based in ego, and so it is fragile and sensitive to criticism. In the face of adversity, confidence, even when misplaced, typically leads to learning from one's mistakes, as well as the ability to adapt and overcome failures. When possessed by pride, obstacles and the inevitable failures of life will typically lead to shame and self-hatred. Pride engenders arrogance and denial, and so one cannot grow when possessed by it. Bruce Lee once said, "Showing off is a fool's idea of glory," and it is not hard to see how many of us have prideful positions and attitudes. Many times this stems from insecurity, and since these feelings are negative, many repress them unconsciously and will carry themselves in a polar manner in spite of their true feelings. The mistake lies in the individual assessment of reward. A confident and reasonable person will see that the rewards they receive from work and behavior are for their actions. A prideful person assumes that it is me being rewarded. So instead of seeing the value of hard work, skills, and progression, a form of entitlement presents itself. And since it is based in ego, one desires further praise and admiration from others to uphold their self-image. A mature person will see the value in what they do in relation to their own morals, experiences, and values. They realize, like many great masters, that it is the value they seize from their work and effort, and not so much what others think of it, or the material rewards. The anthem of a prideful person is, "I have to live through others." Whereas a mature and confident person says, "I have to live with myself." One does not have to look further than the net to see the abundant display of prideful opinions and positions. The far left and right positions of the political spectrum are rife with such attitudes, both of which are engaged in a war of spoils, with moral and ethical opinions being the source of their prideful dogma. All thoughts of racial, mental, or political superiority are merely pathetic attempts of the ego to take credit for something it did nothing to obtain. As I have said before, the ego does not achieve anything. It is an illusion, and an illusion cannot generate authentic choice or truth. It is merely a catalyst for chaos and misguided change. The ego serves a purpose, but like all purposes, it is meant to be transcended and overcome. I suggest you avoid prideful people. Their hubris is their Achilles tendon. You do not need to interfere, lest you become the subject of their inevitable derangement. Life will surely humble them in time.